The Mandalorian is the latest installment in the Star Wars canon. The 16-chapter show streamed its second season finale via Disney Plus on December 18th, 2020. It's no mistake that the closing chapter aired 1 week before Christmas Day, for the arrival of a mysterious green child a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away has a surprising correlation to the events surrounding the advent of a child born in Bethlehem 2,000 years in the past. This is Derek. Let's take a deeper look into the symbolism of the Mandalorian and see how it compares to the Christmas story. Stay tuned. At the end, I will make some predictions about the possible direction for the show's future. Dark times have fallen upon the galaxy. 5 years after Luke Skywalker and the Rebel forces took down the Emperor, the galaxy has descended into a state of chaos. Now that the Empire has fallen, so too has the organizing unit. The darkness here refers to the lack of government and of vision. It's unclear if someone will arise to lead the galaxy out of its lawlessness and unify the randomized parts into a cohesive whole once again. The Christmas story is set in a similar state of darkness. The Roman Empire subjugated the Judeans, restricting national sovereignty and imposing foreign customs and taxes. The Romans enlisted many Judean sons for military and other service throughout the Roman world. Times were hard, and the people could not see a way out. It's in these darkest of days that the light arrives. The show's protagonist, the Mandalorian, or Mando for short, who's played by Pedro Pascal, is a bounty hunter who's possibly suffering from a workaholic disorder. When he agrees to take a high-paying job from an ex-empirical commander called the Client, the tracking fob indicates the proximity of the target by flashing a red light. The closer the target, the brighter the light. Mando is guided by light. In a similar fashion, the great star above Bethlehem serves as an ancient tracking beacon of sorts, guiding shepherds from the hill country and three traveling kings, or magi, from the east to the Christ child. Mando finds the target inside a bunker, wrapped in infant clothes, lying in a hover carriage. The target is a small green child called the Child, though fans endearingly call him Baby Yoda. The child's relation to Master Yoda is not given. Mando makes a sort of sacrifice by killing a fellow member of the guild, IG-11. With a subtle tilt of his helmet, Mando expresses profound wonder. Light shines upon the child as Mando outstretches his hand in a reverential gesture. Mando has found the source of light. The travelers from afar find the Christ child in a cave, wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. That's right, Christian tradition depicts baby Jesus in a cave, not a barn. Sorry, nativity set collectors. The Magi offer their riches fit for a king to the child and bow down in reverence, worshiping him in wonder. It's not a mistake the conclusion of the Mandalorian and the arrival of Christ take place at the winter solstice, for it is in the deepest, darkest, hidden place that the sun is reborn, and each day progressively shines brighter as the sun rises higher. The child is like a seed with the potential to become a mighty leader that unifies the galaxy. The lead antagonist, Moff Gideon, says in chapter 16, "This child is extremely gifted and has been blessed with rare properties that have potential to bring order back to the galaxy." What do we mean by seed here? A seed holds the pattern of identity in potentiality. It must be materialized by a host, like an egg, or the soil, or a womb. The soil receives the acorn, offering minerals to grow the oak tree. The acorn offers a principle that organizes the soil materials into a cohesive identity. John Favreau and the writing team demonstrated the pattern of the seed symbolically and narratively. The child's hover pod is in the shape of an egg. The carriage provides shelter and warmth for the child's growth and protection. The child in the carriage pod is symbolic to the seed inside the egg. Similarly, Mary's womb hosts the Christ child, providing cells and other nutrients to embody his heavenly identity. In chapters 10 and 11, Mando helps a frog lady reunite with her husband, so they can fertilize their eggs and preserve their species. It's the same form of the child, but told in reverse. In the case of the frog lady, Mando delivers her eggs to the father's seed. So too must he deliver the child to its womb. And what womb, you might be wondering. Recall that in chapter 9, Mando says, "I have been quested to deliver the child to his kind," which is a possible reference to the creation story in Genesis, when every living thing was identified according to its kind. The Jedi is the child's kind. The child must be sown into the womb of the Jedi community, who will nourish the Padawan with skills and training. Otherwise, the seed will not properly fertilize. The child will fail to actualize his potential. In comparison, the heavenly seed of God must be sown into the womb of Mary to produce the Christ child. Christians call this miracle the Incarnation. It's a picture of creation, the union of heaven and earth, a principle and actual. Later on, Christ is also the seed buried into the womb of the earth, in death that resurrects in new life, as the king assembling his heavenly kingdom on earth. More on that later. Mando knows, at least vaguely, the child's power, and so do his adversaries. Baby Yoda uses the Force to save the Mandalorian from a deathly blow by a giant rhino monster, and heals Grief Karga's fatal wounds. The antagonist, Dr. Pershing, reports that the child's blood contains high levels of midichlorian, the substance that measures one's capacity to yield the Force. The Mandalorian soon realizes the client's true vampirical aim, to extract the child's blood and terminate him. The Mandalorian's conscience weighs heavily. He holds his ship's round instrument knob, and he recalls the crushed carrier discarded in the trash outside the client's lair, both symbols of the egg without the seed. He realizes that the child's potentiality will never reach actuality. The unsown seed will not become a tree. Mando would be at fault. Similarly, a plot develops to crush the Christ child before he can reach maturity. Herod, the king of the Roman province of Judea, tells the Magi to report back to him the whereabouts of the Christ child, informing them that he wishes to worship the future king. After the Magi make their offerings to the infant, they are intercepted by an angel in a dream, cautioning them of Herod's true intentions to kill the Christ child. Simultaneously, Joseph receives a similar dream. Mandalorian, like Magi and Joseph, makes plans to protect the seed at all costs. The Mandalorian changes course. He takes great risks to rescue the child and flee to foreign planets far away. Mando fights off bounty hunters, stormtroopers, and Moff Gideon to preserve the child from corruption and destruction. The Magi make a risky move as well. Breaking the contractual promise to Herod, they return home another way without consulting the king. It's important to recall that Joseph is not the biological father of Jesus. The first plot to preserve the Christ child begins when Joseph decides to voluntarily adopt the child. Joseph should have returned the pregnant fiancée to her father, who was expected by Judean social norms to put her to death. But instead, Joseph took her and the child into his care. When Joseph becomes aware of Herod's intentions to destroy the Christ child, he leaves his hometown of Bethlehem, making a daring escape to Egypt with his wife and child. In a move of desperation, Herod orders all children in Bethlehem close to the age of Christ to be executed in what became known as the Slaughter of the Innocents. Herod thought that he had eliminated the young contender to his throne, but he was mistaken. Joseph jeopardizes cultural shame and personal safety. The Magi risk the penalty of treason by refusing to heed a direct order from the king, and the Mandalorian gambles losing his place in the Bounty Hunter Guild and the Mandalorian Creed, all to preserve the seed in hope of its germination. All the parts and players are already in place. Once the king arrives, he unifies the parts into a cohesive whole. C.S. Lewis described the incarnation of Christ as the missing part of the work on which the whole plot of the great novel really turned. It illuminates all the parts and pulls them together. The seed of Christ was ultimately sown into the womb of the earth in death on a cross and burial in a tomb, similar to the cave in which he was born. As an acorn must be raised an oak tree, Christ died to the old nature and rose in the new creation. The seed was sown in the soil and sprouted as a tree that seeded a forest. On the other hand, the actualization of the child, whose name was later revealed to be Grogu in chapter 13, is yet to be fully revealed through two seasons. To avoid obvious spoilers, let's just say that the Mandalorian was successful in delivering the child to the Jedi community, and he couldn't have passed the child into more capable hands. The seed has been sown into the ground. Now we must patiently wait to see how the tree will grow, or how the king assembles his kingdom. And this kingly call is not limited to Grogu, for the Mandalorian, whose name was revealed to be Din Djarin, though completing his mission to guard the child, unlocks his higher potential in the season 2 finale. By defeating Moff Gideon in a sword fight, Mando became the rightful bearer to the dark saber. Like a king's scepter, the dark saber signifies Mando as leader of Mandalore. How Mando actualizes his new potential is yet to be seen. Here's my predictions. I come in the form of the following questions. Will Din Djarin accept his calling and become the leader of Mandalore? What will be the extent of Grogu's kingdom? Will he rebuild the ancient Jedi ruins, help Master Luke Skywalker establish the Jedi Academy, or perhaps he will restore the glory of the Republic, reinstituting the order of the galactic government, like Master Yoda? From what we know about the green species, Grogu has hundreds, maybe thousands, of years to make it happen. For now, we know that Grogu, like Christ, has the potential to bring peace on the galaxy and goodwill towards all life forms. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this content helpful. In that case, please click the like button and the subscribe button and let me know what you think in the comment section below. Have a very Merry Christmas. Until next video.